These art museums often seem lustreless, sterile, and as impersonal as mausoleums. Never could they have been what the great master painters would have wished or wanted. Their marvels screwed into the very walls, incarcerated anyway under layers of glaze and slowly darkening varnish. Yet, unexpectedly, bizarrely, today, a gaggle of unseen journeyman decorators have flooded the gallery with the alien reek of fresh new paint. A suppressed coughing ripples the disturbed air and heralds stranger metaphysical transformations. For parched pigments on scores of antique canvases, arid oils on old wood panels exhale a sustained but distinctly audible sigh. And now, the old masters themselves, invisible in adjoining studios or chambers, bend once more over kettles of oak tree bark and bovine urine. There's the sound of lapis lazuli, no doubt, being smashed and ground to a vivid dust. The preparation of linseed and walnut oils. They habitually draw together into pairs or groups to share good news, review fortuitous innovations, techniques and tricks, and thus conspire in that stimulating stench of wood smoke, piss and stale hoof glue to delight, to move, and to utterly astonish you.